Welcome back, Foodlings, to Let's Play Mass Effect 2. my. I'm the RPG chick, your hostess with the mostest. We are going to finish exploring this, well, it's the Far Rim. We just finished, we looked through Dolan, I guess it's pronounced, and Heastrim is where we helped Tally. So we're done with there. That one. Ma'at. Alright, the Ma'at system. Which doesn't seem to have very much in it because 75% is done already. Seriously? One planet. Amut. I don't know what's going on with my voice, guys. I'm very sorry. Let me get a drink. Amut is an enormous hydrogen helium giant with a mass approximately 9 times that of Jupiter and nearly 2900 times that of Earth. Despite massive pressure, its core has failed to ignite in a fusion reaction, qualifying it as a failed star. It is believed to have captured all other planet-sized bodies in the solar system as moons or impact events, leading to its name, Devourer. Not intimidated by this phenomena, the Geth have colonized many of Amut's moons and skimmed the hydrogen from Amut's upper atmosphere. Travel advisory. Amut is in Geth space. All civilian traffic is prohibited. Moderate results. Yeah, we did a bunch of upgrades, so we need everything again. Good enough, I guess.
Probe launched.
It's not getting very high, is it? There we go.
Launching probe.
Iridium time. There's some palladium, yeah. Platinum.
Probe launched.
Seems like a good spot. And that's good. Oh, actually, I'll take these.
Probe away.
Good enough. Interesting. They just have this random system with one planet. Okay, we've explored the Far Rim and back to the mass relay. That star is pretty cool, huh? Red giant. Where to now? Fireworker stuff. We got help Jack soon. Let's check out the Prothean ruin eventually. Hecate. Alright, let's get some fuel. Okay, so this is... Let's start with the innermost planet, which would be this one. This little one here. Kerr. A dry, desolate planet, Kerr is temperate but supports little life above the microscopic level. Its Earth-like temperatures and gravity make it an appealing place to build habitation hideaways, attracting Batarian slavers and criminals who can't afford more luxurious safe houses on other planets. Its forgiving nitrogen-helium atmosphere makes EVAs possible with a minimal amount of equipment. A breathing mask and warm clothing is usually sufficient. Mining and other legitimate activities are few and far between on Kerr. The planet's crust is largely free of precious metals, instead producing kilometers upon kilometers of dolomitic limestone, calcite, and gypsum. Alliance Bulletin. Geth have been encountered in the Hecate system. All civilian traffic is prohibited. Alright. We're gonna get some stuff here.
Launching probe.
Small amounts. Where's the richness? Oh, there we go. The richness of this world.
Probe launched.
Okay.
Launching probe.
Nice.
Launching probe. Launching probe.
Some iridium.
Probe away.
You got large spikes. This is a rich planet.
Probe away.
And it's making me rich in the resources that I need. I missed one here.
Probe launched.
Okay. Second planet from the sun. Very pretty. Triodia. A modestly sized gas giant with an icy core, Triodia's hydrogen and methane atmosphere gives it a bluish color. It has 14 moons named after Asari virtues. I wonder the names of the moons. That sounds really interesting. Alliance Bulletin. Geth have been encountered in the Hecate system. All civilian traffic is prohibited. Same. Moderate results. You deplete the resources from these Geth worlds, so they have nothing.
Probe launched. Launching probe.
Any more? See?
probe away.
Already we've got it down to poor. Didn't take much for that. Third planet and the last planet. Bothros. A rock and ice planet, Bothros is home to a scientific curiosity. Evidence of a primate-like spacefaring civilization was found frozen in its equatorial ice, ranging from melted fragments of metal to preserved remains of the creatures still wearing suits for extravehicular activity. Further exploration revealed that their habitation centers were vaporized by orbital bombardments from railgun-like weapons, hitting with a force of approximately 120 kilotons of TNT. Wow. Only those that fled or happened to be away from the habitats were preserved in the ice, where they died of asphyxiation. This unknown species did not come from Asteria, but scientific teams are looking for evidence that they visited there. It is difficult to believe that they would colonize a frozen rock like Bothros and ignore a lush garden world. Their world of origin is also a mystery. Same warning. Now that would be funny, because I'm immediately thinking to... I know there was at least one instance where we sent a chimpanzee into outer space, and imagine if we launched them into outer space, like a bunch of them, and maybe they went suspended animation or something, and this is the first world that they came to, possibly. It's quite a stretch, isn't it? But I have quite an imagination. So they were woken from their suspended animation upon arrival. You know, automated systems detected they were near a planet, and they came to, and they started doing stuff, and they started mating, and there we go. They're walking around in spacesuits and stuff, and they're primates. It would be funny, though. This is rich in resources. Nice.
Probe away.
So this is the system we're in, Asteria. I didn't even, like, take note of that.
Launching probe.
Two birds with one stone. Actually got three at one time.
Probe launched. Launching probe.
All the way up there.
Probe away.
Wait. There's some... Can I get that higher? I love the cute noise it makes.
Launching probe.
Got a little element zero and some palladium there. Oh, nice. That is very nice.
Probe away.
I love when a planet be having the element zero. That's awesome.
Probe away.
Any more?
Launching probe. Launching probe. Launched.
Almost done with our palladium. We'll stop collecting it soon. Once we get over that 100k mark. Okay. Hey, Kate. Done. Let's get some more probes, because they use a lot. Got a bunch. I think we'll save the fireworker for last. We'll just go look over here. Sheol. Oh, you're kidding. Another one with one tiny... Look how small it is, too. And the other one had one planet in the far end, but... This is small.
I have detected an anomaly.
You have? Gei Hinnom. I don't know how you say that. A nearly atmosphereless, tidally locked planet orbiting a red dwarf star, Gei Hinnom was the first place human explorers discovered a dedicated Prothean burial ground. Oh, this is for the Prothean burial site? While a few sites were saved for posterity, Eldfell Ashland Mining successfully lobbied to scout the rest of the planet for Element Zero and soon was embroiled in a scandal. Mining teams were looting grave sites, searching for Ezo and other treasures, and many got rich off the so-called cemetery business. While EAM officially brought a stop to the looting, its mining teams remain on the planet, prospecting the unclaimed territory and taking the ore to the Pamiat system for refining. So, yeah, that's the difference. Posterity and prospecting. Travel advisory. Armed conflicts have broken out between miners and scientists staking claims to Prothean ruins. Visitors are advised to employ security while exploring unknown regions of the planet. Population 11,503. A trace of atmospheric pressure. Surface temperature is 35 Celsius in the habitable zone, or 108 Celsius, or minus 120 Celsius in the uninhabitable zone. Scanning. Lieutenant something something of the port ship.
Repeat, this is Lieutenant Forzon Boss Idina. Pilot of the scout ship Fine.
The scout ship Fine?
Repeat, this is Lieutenant Forzon Boss Idina.
Launching probe.
Lieutenant something or other.
I have found something.
Surface scans show evidence of a shipwreck meeting Quarian design specifications. Identity of ship unknown. Number of life signs detected in vicinity uncertain. Local wildlife may interfere with accuracy of biological scan. Well, let's scan for other stuff because we're rich in resources. So. Investigate Quarian crash. Thank you. So I can see my scanner results. That's just how concerned we are about this.
Probe away.
Press can bring Tally with us, so she can calm that lunatic down. I didn't even understand what her name was.
Probe launched.
Well, it wasn't a very clear transmission either. Oh, look at that. How about that easel, y'all?
Probe away.
You don't use it very often, but it's just nice to have more of it, you know what I'm saying?
Launching probe.
Nice.
Probe launched.
Let's see if I can hit 30k with that. That'd be awesome. There's a little bit there. Nice.
Probe away.
Getting closer.
Launching probe.
I even got a little there.
Probe away.
Cool.
Probe launched.
How did I miss that?
Probe launched. Launching probe. Away.
Great.
Probe launched.
Sorry guys, this is probably boring. But I'm finding a lot. And I keep finding more, look at that.
Launching probe.
I did it! I passed 30k. I think it might have been around 30k anyway. Kind of stopped watching it, you know. And good enough. We really mine the crap. Yes, yeah, it's depleted. It was rich. Not anymore. Right, so there's a Quarian, so I'm gonna bring. That's not Tally. What the hell? Loyalty is normal, right? So let's see. So she. We don't have any quest for her? At least not yet. We have to do Morden's quest, Grunt, Jacob, and Jack. Well, a good time. Let's add Tally and Morden. They're an interesting pair, aren't they? Almost like, you know, the Meek team. And that's not a jibe from me. It's the meek shall inherit the earth, I feel. Not sure how, but, you know, it's been our side. Oh, she has a combat drone? What? Command your very own combat drone. Nice. So, fly longer, make it more durable, sure. Increase frequency of attack. That's pretty cool. I like that. AI hacking. Hacks a synthetic enemy to attack its former allies. Oh, I like that. Crowd control is very important. And we don't really see a lot of crowd control other than just immobilizing people. Trying to make her a well-rounded tally. I like this combat drone thing. Evolve it. Okay, so electric shock damages target health, armor, and biotic barriers, or explosive. Explodes when destroyed. Pulsing energy that inflicts high damage on all nearby enemies. I'm wondering if she can summon this drone more than once. Like... I think explosive, what the hell not. Machinist. Hacking. Machinist. There we go. Now, what is Tally using? Eviscerator shotgun is good. This is the upgrade to the Predator heavy pistol, so yeah, she could use that. Oh, why hello? Aren't you a cutie? Great. Palladium. Near the landing site, we saw one of them. Personal logs. Commence pilot's record. What's a commence pilot? Are we commencing reading the pilot's record? Scout ship Siniad. Is that what she said? Her Lieutenant Forzan Vas Edena? Okay. We managed to escape the Geth's notice thanks to some clever work in silencing Siniad's engines, but the strain on the old ship was too much. The best we can hope for is to find a friendly spot somewhere in the Sheol system. Our reports show that that isn't extremely likely. We were nervous scouting this close to the Perseus Veil, and we were right to be. At this point, I'm afraid we might never see the fleet again. With everything the Siniad has been through, it seems like an ignoble end. First few hours. The landing was rough, but we managed to salvage from the wreckage, the things we need to survive. Unfortunately, I hear that. Lieutenant Commander Gorlat didn't make it, leaving me the senior officer in charge. We've scattered the landscape and found the planet to be extremely hostile. We don't dare remove our environment suits here. We're all hoping to be rescued before there's any danger of exposure. Oh my god, you never remove those things. Missing survivors. I don't know who or what is taking them, but we've now lost more than half the crew who survived the crash. We hope to build a camp here to survive until... the Edena found our beacon, but something is hunting us. I have to keep the crew together the best I can. We will send out a search party when the day comes. I will find my crew and we will do whatever it takes to return to the Edena. Okay. Huntings. Oh, all of a sudden I got so quiet. Alright, so there's aminals. And something big. I don't know if that was a ship or a creature. If it's a creature, we're in trouble. You see anything through here? No. It almost looks like I can go through there. Sorry guys, I'm extremely tired. Explosive containers. Oh!
Quarian life signs are stabilized. I recommend securing the area in preparation for shuttle extraction.
Those are those things.
Ambush.
Coming this way? It's a Varan, it's almost dead.
Next.
Incineration blast. What am I using? Oh, what the hell am I using this for? I must have switched to that. Yeah, and I forgot to switch back. Yeah, I remember now. I don't like the control on this thing. Ugh, more. Will they just keep spawning?
Just the thing to help.
Explosive drone.
Nothing faster than Jatiga Boss Paws.
Cool. Well, I'm guessing it's time to get out of here. Is there anything else around here? I don't want to miss anything. What about this? Alright, let's get out. Something big's coming. Those aren't that big. What are we doing? Oh, cool! Can we bring the lieutenant?
Coordinates received. Be DNA inbound for pickup. You've done us a great service. Expect to hear from the captain.
Okay, good. I did take her, right? Found an extracted Quarian survivor. Notified Adena of Siniad scout ship location. 125 experience, 7500 credits, 2000 palladium. Oop. message, Kelly?
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
I must be psychic. The Sidiad, thank you. From Captain Isvin Malvas Edena. Commander Shepard, please accept my sincere appreciation for your efforts. Never mind, I'm not going to try to do that. In locating the wreckage of the Sinead, that ship has a storied history with both the Migrant Fleet and Cerberus, and we are pleased to know that her wreckage can be salvaged by my people. In finding and stabilizing Lieutenant Forzan, you have returned to the flotilla one of her newest and most honored heroes. Your efforts in furthering the Quarian search for a new homeworld will be remembered. Yay. Good to know. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.